Good evening, New Zealand. I'm Mark Sainsbury. Tonight on Close-Up.
It's the greatest show on earth.
The Kiwi daredevil going deep into danger to capture this.
The noise, the heat, the falling rocks and the toxic gas. Wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
Close-Up is brought to you by the powerful Kia Sorento R. Kia, the power to surprise.
It's been called the most incredible volcano video ever. Geoff Mackley, the Auckland filmmaker, lowered himself into the heart of an active volcano to capture amazing pictures of boiling lava. His death-defying trip has been watched by more than 1 million people on YouTube and grabbed the attention of television networks around the world. So Kate Lynch went to find out if he really is as crazy as he looks.
It's just the most amazing sight you could ever see in your life. There's nothing that comes close to this.
It's hard to explain the sound of a lava lake the size of 4 football fields of furiously boiling rock is mind-blowing. And the heat is the greatest show on earth.
Geoff Mackley is inside the heart of an active volcano, hanging precariously above a violently boiling lava lake.
The noise, the heat, the falling rocks and the toxic gas, wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
Vanuatu's Marram volcano dominates the island of Ambrim.
It's called the Island of Black Magic, actually.
Oh, this is just absolutely incredible. I've been coming here for 13 years trying to get the footage that I'm just getting now, and there's nothing better, ever.
It's taken Mackley 13 years because of the atrocious conditions.
With it, almost every previous time I've been there, the trip has ended in some kind of disaster. We've had our campsite trashed with flash floods. Cyclones hit our campsite. We've been rescued by helicopter.
So this time, Mackley made sure he was prepared.
When you're up there, if something goes wrong, you have to be able to rescue yourself. You can't call in Westpac Rescue or the fire service.
He airlifted 8 tonnes of equipment up the volcano, borrowed the clothing needed to withstand the unbearable heat and intense smoke and ash.
I searched the world for, on the internet for a heat-proof suit, and then I found out the fire chief of Kaiapoi, who I've known for years, is making them himself in his garage.
Ah, it's all ropes, it's all harnesses, it's just a little bit more sulphur and a little bit more heat.
And he and his team abseiled 500 metres inside the crater. That's twice the height of the Auckland Sky Tower.
What did that feel like?
I guess it's probably like as if you're standing on top of Mount Everest.
The noise, the heat, everything combined is just incredible. You cannot describe it. It's like the noisiest washing machine you've ever heard in the hottest laundrette. It's crazy.
As a cameraman, you know when you're shooting something, whether you've got, as they call it, the money shot. It all comes down to you're looking through the viewfinder and you know you've got the shot that is going to wow the world.
A New Zealand filmmaker and his crew have made a dangerous descent into the heart of a volcano.
Hey, Mr. Mackley, good morning to you.
Yes, good morning.
Wow the world it did. The footage has been viewed by more than 1 million people on YouTube and catapulted Mackley to international stardom.
I woke up to about 1,200 emails. I was getting 3 or 4 phone calls a minute for 18 hours from every news network in the world.
But Mackley's no stranger to television. Over the past 30 years, he's filmed hurricanes, cyclones, typhoons and tornadoes.
Well, I just basically travel the world filming Mother Nature at her worst.
For now, he's back in Auckland planning his next mission. Next time, he's planning to go where no man has gone before.
We're going to go right to the bottom and right to the very edge of the lava lake, as the molten rock fountain's 100 metres above me. It's going to be the ultimate.
Are you not afraid of the risk?
You can't worry about the risk. I mean, the biggest risk
we've got is a big earthquake happening while we're on the side of this cliff, because if that happens, we're toast.
Are you crazy?
Ever since being a small boy, I was always doing something crazy. But I've now just realised that if you do something crazy and film yourself doing it, it's a ticket to a pretty good way of life, actually.
Yes, Geoff, you are crazy, but we love it.